On the medical watch, a concern about COVID testing following the vaccine.
Our medical reporter Dina Baer explains how the shot could potentially impact a person's next COVID test.
When someone gets the COVID-19 vaccine, it triggers an immune response that will help them fight the virus that causes the deadly disease.
It is a messenger RNA vaccine. So unlike old vaccines that inject either an inactivated virus or a piece of viral protein, what this does is it injects a little snippet of viral RNA, which is taken up into the muscle and actually into the cells that help us make antibodies in our own bodies.
For years, people have been taking the flu vaccine to boost an immune response against the flu virus. But when they take it in a certain form, it can elicit a false positive flu test.
The flu mist, I think, is actually inactivated virus. What we have seen is that with flu mist, there's a little bit of that inactivated virus still in the nasal area, the nasal pharynx. And so if one samples a patient for an influenza test too soon after they've gotten the flu mist, you can actually pick up that virus and detect it. It'll give you a positive on a viral PCR for influenza.
The COVID vaccine is designed differently. It does not contain actual virus, merely a part of the spike protein in the virus, the compound that helps it invade and take hold of healthy cells.
It's not the whole virus. It's not inactivated virus, but it's just a little snippet of viral protein, and that will stimulate our bodies to make an antibody response against that antigen.
But North Shore University Health Systems' Dr. Karen Call says she and other pathologists wondered whether the viral protein expressed through cells in the body would trigger a similar false positive test result for COVID among vaccine recipients.
We've actually been looking at that. And most of the assays do not target the spike protein. I can't tell you that all assays are free of that potential interaction.
Like many things with this novel coronavirus, there are no definitive answers, but experts hope the COVID tests will be accurate and the vaccine will be effective. Dina Baer, WGN News.
And Dina tells us the vaccines had an efficacy of 95% during the studies. It remains to be seen how effective, though, they'll be in real-world conditions.